Most of these film industry guys think they only have dads. The rest are bastards. If these are bad times, then why are there bad times? And it's maybe I'm wrong. Maybe there are no good filmmakers. Because if you were a good filmmaker, and if you had the vision or if that story was kind of grabbing you, or if a film was grabbing you, there was no way you won't make it.
No way you won't make it. But how do you do it? Because you know it's an expensive medium, and you can't.
Yeah, no. Take get friends, exploit people. You know, I mean, sell your house. Do anything, you know, I mean, I don't know, why is it so important, anything else then? And nothing else should be important. I mean, and there should be a support system within society, if not from the government or something, from within people, within communities, within friends, who could support, you know, how much does it take for a guy to live, you know, I mean, somebody can live in somebody's house and eat, you know, beyond that, I'm saying in the 70s, 80s, there was this kind of support system amongst people also. So the point is not that they are no rich and it's back to make money, but why should everybody want to make money? I mean, that in a society, the poet has a place, the dissenter has a place. The entrepreneur has a place, and you know, and everybody has a place, and it's important. The even the unconventional bad boy who sort of breaks out of, I mean, what is a world? You know, you sort of first grab something, and then you make some laws around it to protect what you've grabbed. You know, so there are people who will break the law, because how else are they supposed to do anything except by stretching it, you know, by you know, so I mean, you have to stretch, you have to go around.
Have you stretched enough, you think?
No. Why? No, I don't know, because I really don't know. I mean, everything will be an excuse, you know, and everything, you can bullshit around everything, you know, but it's just that you haven't, and you should.
But what's stopping you?
I don't know. I mean, just the fact that maybe it's a laziness of the mind. It's a, you know, that you don't sit enough, and that, you know, you waste your time in and there's too much time wasted in other things, you know, in getting a film and in wanting to also kind of half belong. In a sense, to be, you know, not totally be rejected by India. You know, already you are kind of, you sit in an award function, and there are 50 film industry luminaries, some kids who you know, used to come to your office, and they've just made it, and they look at you, and because there is some star and some guy whose dad you met, and he thinks he's kind of French, but he's actually just a lout who's not studied anything, and he's made one film which has become a hit, and he already sneers at you, you know, he already looks at you like that. I mean, he's film was copied from here, is copied from there, but he's got this whole halo of a genius, you know. Most of these film industry guys think they only have dads. The rest are bastards. Right? Most of them have this view that we didn't have fathers. So anybody who didn't make money, who was not a trader, who didn't sell his soul for some crap, is not worth knowing. Just because they can buy taste and hire some bad designer to do up their homes in a pseudo so-called tasteful way, and they know the names of some French wines with the, you know, they're comic. It's funny. So I mean, there are many people in these 25 years that have come and gone, you know. Every film industry boy who's brought up in Juhu and Bandra calls people who come from other towns Bernese. I mean, that's kind of racist. Yeah. They tell jokes against African Americans. They think they are white. They live in some fantasy land called, and they walk in their heads in some LA street all the time. They're not walking here. They're schizophrenics. And they have managed to create an artificial world where they also control a lot of things. So I mean, they push out people, but they, you know, every now and then they can't because of money reasons. They will have to tolerate an Abhinav Kashyap who'll walk in, who'll break it open. So they'll have to tolerate a Raju Hirani. They don't like his success. They don't. They don't like Raju's success. He's kind of modest and simple, and things that things come with great difficulty. He's not wearing the halo of a genius. He's trying hard. He's, you know, has the ability to laugh at himself and his own background and a lot of things. He has, you know, an idea of education. He knows and has actually been to universities and colleges, and, you know,
he's rooted.
And there is a lot of, you know, and these guys are not.
You can't shoot here because, I mean, say, this is part of your history. You studied here, a whole generation of students studied here. You know,
I mean, I
we
don't
were
know
part of
any,
our, part
any
of
kind
us.
Of security,
no, I mean, this is part of me. So if I try and talk about myself, this is only a visual medium. If you're a writer, for instance, you could do it. Problem with these institutions, which are very moralistic, right, and have a notion of things which sometimes I, in my childhood, used to consider kind of racist. It seemed to have, you know, oh, boys will be disturbed, oh, people will be, instead of saying, oh, well, there's this ex-student from here who could give them a opening into another kind of life, or, you
maybe
know.
Inspire them a bit.
Maybe, whatever. Or just kind of provoke them a bit. Right? So, you know, it's like some guy from the sinful land of films has come and they have to protect.
Maybe that's what it is.
Maybe
they see this as the dirty world of films.
Maybe. Maybe that's how it is. And maybe the parents would agree. Even though they all read gossip magazines. And the only thing that they see is television shows where film stars are there.
Bollywood is not the be-all and end-all of any. You cannot cannibalize everything. That there is music here, that there was dance, that there was poetry of a very high caliber outside of Bollywood. And every folk tune that you copy doesn't belong to you. And that there is a genius outside which because of your the ownership of traders of this business, you know, everything becomes a barter deal and credit accrues to Shah Jahan, not to the architect. Now you see songs being played in television, and you don't see the name of the lyricist or the music composer. How odd is that? It's a song by, you know, Hua Sahir, man. So, I mean, because you paid him money, he wrote, your film worked because of that song. But the credit is his. How can you take away credit? So those battles are won. So the capitalist countries which these guys salivate over, these battles have already been won. So the writer's name is up there in America before the director.
Asrar ji keh rahe hain ki ve Mumbai ke director hain, lekin main bata raha hu ve pehle Sagar ke director rahe. Bahut hardik swagat hai aapka, bahut aatmi swagat hai. हम आपको हमेशा याद करते हैं, वी रिमेम्बर यू, वी लव यू. हम आपको प्रेम करते हैं, चाहते हैं और खूब याद करते हैं. आपने सागर का खूब नाम रोशन किया है. आपका हार्दिक स्वागत और वंदन है. नमस्कार.
लॉट ऑफ पीपल हैव दैट नीड टू बी अ रॉक स्टार फॉर पीपल टू गो, यू नो, हां, व्हेन दे वॉक आउट, यू नो, दे वांट टू बी स्मदर्ड, दे वांट टू फ्लैश बल्ब्स किकिंग अमंगस्ट देम. दोज दैट हैव दिस चाइल्डलाइक डिजायर, some make great films also.
Do you have it?
Yeah. Sometimes. I mean, but it's not. It's there. More and more, it's coming inside me.
It's coming more now.
More now. But you know, the problem with some people and your backgrounds is that, you know, you cannot be servants. For me, maybe I make films because otherwise I feel too anxious. I mean, what else is the reason?
So how does this harmonize with your wanting to be popular? Why is this coming in now?
I don't don't know. I mean, it's a why is there also why do you make films? You know, is the question. So I mean, I don't know if more and more people see them, then maybe you are affecting people. You know, maybe in some way you are valid. If you are kind of you can be like Oliver Stone was talking, and he's saying that I make films for a future. I don't know. I'm recording my time. I'm full. So that's also maybe interesting. Why are you making films? But you know, if you also connect with somebody in Jamshedpur, Jabalpur, Jagdalpur, wherever, you know, who doesn't know you.
Is there an ego thing somewhere?
Yeah, maybe it's there. Maybe it's feudal. Who knows? Maybe you want to be Top Gun, and you know, you, when you walk somewhere, you want to be recognized.
Do you?
No, not much. I mean, I really don't know. I'm very uncomfortable with being watched all the time or something. I think it's quite boring.
So what is it then? Why is it so important to you? You've made a film like Hazaaron Baatein, which, you know, people will remember.
But I like the fact that people like Hazaaron and it connects with them and it affects them in some way. And that, you know, many sorts of people like Hazaaron. And that I, you know, it's not, and that it has become something outside of me, which people sort of take, and maybe they reject all my other films, but they take this film into themselves and it becomes their friend and they go with it somewhere. So if you create objects of value.
But it's not a quote-unquote popular film, it's a cult film. It's a, you know,
no, I don't know. So I'm saying maybe you want to be more popular. Maybe you want more people to like your other film. And maybe you're just sort of trying to see that, you know, you continue. And it's a quest for some kind of immortality, which may itself be a foolish quest.
क्या है ये भी देखा जाए इन्होंने बाकी काम किया कि नहीं किया क्या फिर पॉर्न का डेफिनेशन क्या है वो देखा जाए कोई ऐसी फिल्म हो सकता है जिसमें कोई सेक्सुअल कंटेंट है वो देख रहे थे कि नहीं बहरहाल अगर वो पॉर्न देख रहे थे तो मैं तो उसका समर्थन करता नहीं हूँ थोड़ा मानसिक उनका विकास कम है और वो मेरे ख्याल से लायक नहीं होंगे क्योंकि पॉर्न इंडस्ट्री जो है बहुत एक्सप्लॉयटेटिव इंडस्ट्री है उसमें बहुत शोषण होता है लोगों का औरतों का ये वो तो आप किस चीज को आप पहले पोर्नोग्राफी कह रहे हैं वो डिफाइन कीजिए फिर मैं बोलूं कि ये गलत है सही है विधानसभा में अगर वो बैठे देख रहे हैं तो ये तो फिर गलत है ही है क्योंकि आप किसी जनता का उस वक्त रिप्रेजेंटेशन कर रहे हैं लेकिन मुझे ख्याल है बहुत ज्यादा बड़ा बनाया जा रहा है इसको आप मतलब ठीक है अगर किसी ने एलिमेंटरली एक बार कुछ देख लिया और वो टाल दिया तो पता इतनी क्या बड़ी बात है लेकिन मतलब अगर वो बैठ के सिर्फ यही करते हैं और रिप्रेजेंट नहीं कर रहे हैं लोगों को और पॉन देख रहे हैं तो जो भी पॉन सिर्फ देख रहा है उसको मैं वॉयर कहता हूँ थोड़ा सा मतलब मुझे उसकी मानसिक क्षमता पे शक होता है और तो फिर वो आपको कैसे रिप्रेजेंट करेगा उस पर मेरा डाउट बढ़ता है थोड़ा अरे ऐसे आप लोग बहस करेंगे तो कोई वोट देने नहीं जाएगा भाई इलेक्शन का माहौल है थोड़ा सा आपस में थोड़ा बात तो कीजिए इससे वार्तालाप तो आप तो एक दूसरे के ऊपर चिल्ला रहे हैं
The taste of the powerful, the taste of those, they should be wise enough to know that the opposites should also exist, that minorities should exist, that other things should exist. They all want to obliterate everything. So because they don't understand classical music, a 1,000-year history should go. 2,000-year history should go. Because that moron doesn't like it. Because some trader from somewhere doesn't like it, everything should go. Why? I mean, so the idea of dance of India, I mean, people dance so badly on shows, you know. But in India, there's a great tradition of dance, you know. That's all gone. You don't see that tradition only. So if somebody, young person came, you go somewhere and you go anywhere, oh, India, Bollywood. It's all, you know, what the hell was that, you know.
How do you feel and how do you react to those kinds of people? I mean,
I stopped going so much to festivals, that's why. Ever since this nonsense is starting to happen, I've stopped going. Because the questions asked are so basic and so foolish that my interest in all of these things is diminishing. Because, you know, I mean, it's a... I think I'm being overreactive here, and I should change, you know, and I will go back to being half of what I was, you know, because I've started suddenly not going anywhere. Then I find myself, oh, not like this year, I just allowed myself not to go to Goa for the festival. I didn't even miss it for a single day. I never even thought that I should be there. It didn't enter my head. When they call me somewhere, I get bored. I think, you know, kya hoga, wahi bakwas hogi, na cinema ke bare mein kuch hoga, na isse koi film ko madad hogi, na, you know, na, I will not be able to make a better film because of this. You know, what will happen? I will just talk some crap, some bullshit, I will con some people, I pretend.
There's a friend of mine, Hikmat Nasser, who's a Palestinian student. He had this odd laugh, you know, whenever I think of Sagar, sometimes I stand here. When I was standing there yesterday at my house, I was remembering, because he had this laugh which went and I could hear it when he was coming down, I could hear it there. So that's how I knew Hikmat was coming down. Then we fought over a girl. Yeah, first time I, you know, that kind
of thing. First time what?
You know, we fell in love with the same girl, I think, something like that. All right, something. I remember you started getting really upset.
And how did that end?
It ended up by saying, fuck, it was too stupid.
If you had a family to actually, you know, sustain children, would you be able to take the risks you've taken?
I think I would have been compelled to, and they would have left me.
How can children leave you?
Oh, you know, the wife would have taken them away somewhere and married again.
You really think so?
I think so. I think I would have been desperately unhappy doing anything else. And I'm not capable of doing much else. So maybe this is a conscious, unconscious choice, you know. If you are built a certain way, it's just being built a certain way and only being able to do this. What I'm doing. So naturally, I'm trying to make a, you know, or some films that you tend to make because, you know, they are simpler and will be more enjoyable. I'm not saying that I'm not doing that. I'm doing that with Yesari, but it's coming out of me naturally. It's not something that I wouldn't be able to sit somewhere and do something and take humiliation and sit, you know, and pretend I'm a director and have everybody else dictate everything to me and not have fun. Basically, not enjoy that process. If I'm not enjoying that process, then I can't be there. That's a problem. I get my rocks off by doing this. I think it's a mental block or whatever it is. It's a failing. I remember in school in Patiala, you know, when I went from Lucknow to Patiala, the first school they took me to, I didn't enjoy it at all. I was finding, you know, the whole atmosphere weird, you know. So they thought I was retarded. Really, they thought they called my father and think they said that there is something seriously wrong with your son. My father had to shift me from that school.
I'm really, really, really happy to stand here in front of you. This is a really moving. I don't know if you can get it, but this is really moving for me to be standing here in this school and where I first came and I was class one and I didn't know what I was going to be. This is where I probably, some of my formative years were formed. Maybe all the teachers that were there influenced me in the right ways or the wrong ways, whichever way you look at it. It's great, that time of life, and I would exchange every part of my achievement to be there and for you to be here. Road which will be written here. This is the main gate. The name was Siddhi Sadan, which is kind of erased. The wall is the same. This is what remains of the house, you know, the same. And probably the gate is the same. I have a great fun in that house, no?
Exactly.
Yeah, so you can go anywhere. I remember all parts of that house very well.
That Angan was quite important, and I still remember there was all these people and And in front, my great-grandfather was getting massaged. My grandmother was muttering. My father and everybody was having intellectual conversations. And there was an old lady, you know, she was whom we called Mossi Ajia. She was some kind of cousin of my grandmother's, you know. She'd been widowed at 4 or something. So she lived with us. And she lived alone in a room where she even saved the you know, anything that she had, like if she had a moonpali, she saved the chilka, you know. And it was in some, you know, she didn't, you know, so her room was full of her possessions. And her possessions were those chilkas, you know, or something like that. You know, there was a lot of stuff in her room which was kind of useless. And then she was also kind of very, she lost her, in Lucknow, many people, I think, old, decadent, you know, feudal traditions. I think there are many sad stories, you know, and many, I mean, under the garb of or the cover of all this Tamiz, Tehzeeb, there's a lot of violence. You know, the violence inflicted upon human beings through tradition, you know. So here she was, she had lost her mind a bit, and she used to, and in the old houses, there's never, the bathroom is never attached to their room. So the on one side of the angan is the bathrooms, and the other side is the room. And so she had a bath, and then she put her white sari, kind of, and draped it around her, you know, put it on her shoulders, and forgot to wear it. And she walked naked, you know, through the angan, you know, mm-hmm. right? And everyone kind of knew this as sometimes. So sometimes they just turned, you know, okay. away everywhere. So it's like a freeze, you know. And as she walked past, then everybody continued like it was normal, you know.
I mean, I lived there for a long time. Went back till I was 21, 22, 23.
Well, those kind of houses are anyway, they are kind of gone now in our from our consciousness, modern consciousness or like.
There's still some people who live in those bigger houses. No? In Jaipur and places like
smaller cities, I guess.
Smaller cities, yeah. It's very difficult for anybody to maintain that kind of house. It'd be, you know, impossible.
Do you recommend living like this if it is within your means? Do you recommend it for people or people of different temperaments will cope differently?
You know, I mean, I don't know if people can live together because it's difficult to live together with different temperaments. So people have their own trips and people have their own aspirations and people have their own other people whom they want to be with. And families sort of form and disintegrate and new families form.
Today you can't avoid listening to silly Hindi film songs. Those days you couldn't avoid listening to great poetry. I mean, I you know, a lot of people will say, why do you know this and how do you know that? But, you know, I don't know. But it's just around. So you heard it. So even if you want to avoid hearing, say, poetry, if you grew up in Lucknow as a kid, every guy who came to your father's house quoted some poetry. So for some example of everything was poetry, you know, I mean, like if somebody wanted to comment on a situation, then they quoted Ghalib, you know. So, I mean, how do you know Ghalib? Because, you know, I don't know. I've never consciously studied him, you know, but, you know, that's everybody else did, you know, so they did it for me.
The time will come when with elation you will greet yourself arriving at your own door, in your own mirror, and each will smile at the other's welcome and say, sit here, eat. You will love again the stranger who was yourself. Give wine, give bread. Give back your heart to itself, to the stranger who has loved you all your life, whom you ignored for another, who knows you by heart. Take down the love letters from the bookshelf, the photographs, the desperate notes. Peel your own image from the mirror. Sit, feast on your life. One of the great poems of all time.
Lamartine is one of these Europeans who became very Indian. It also has a connection with Calcutta, and you have the Lamartine there. And I was trying to shoot up a... I wanted to do some sequences here, and I remember the principal, and I was refused permission. And I remember the principal, talking to me, and then he said, what kind of a film is it? And if it's an anti-British film, we don't allow it. I get a little amused by this. All this idiocies and...
I think on my face, there's a lot of people who are in positions of power and have had fun in their lives and have got away by doing crap all. I don't think they like me. There's some problem there, you know. I mean, not that some people don't like me. I've noticed that people who like me are people in not very powerful positions of power. It's true.
Are you subversive? Is that it?
I have no idea. I mean, I don't want to ascribe things to myself, but I noticed that I maybe, you know, maybe it's, you know, you're kind of at a certain age and you know, people like to pat the young and you should have, whatever it is. I have no idea. There can be many reasons for. My generation has kept their little prince and princesses away from reality and history and memory, and told them that they live in this la-la land where, don't worry, daddy's here. You know, that's the problem.
How are you in terms of financial stability? I mean, for example, if you do not earn anything for 3 years...
Right? Well, sure. No, I live... film to film. Yeah.
So that's part of it, that if you don't do a film, you don't make money, basically.
Well, basically, I don't. I'll have to do something else. I haven't got any inheritance. And I didn't make ads, I didn't make... I just did television in those days.
What about ad films? I mean, so many of your contemporaries also have done ad films to supplement their... I mean, take the pressure away from doing,
I think ad film companies don't like me. There's some problem there. Because, I mean, not that I've actively ever wooed anyone or gone to anyone to say, give me work or whatever. I wouldn't do some ads. But I would do some. Maybe I just... They think I'm not good enough for that or... Whatever it takes to make an ad film or something. Maybe it's an act of genius, which I don't know. And everyone should put that limit and say no. I mean, that's when he's not a whore.
I think it started really well. Why don't ad...
I mean, not that I mind whores, the real ones, They at least have... And this is a very fashionable thing to say, but I really don't have a moral judgment on them. As long as they're doing it of their own free will. I mean, just because I use the word whore, I'm just clarifying this. And I don't think every whore is doing it out of a free will, like some people suggest. So you know, those like, and there is child prostitution, and I'm not for that. I mean, just to clarify some basic things. All of them said this is the worst script they've ever read in their lives. The worst. Now, that's the advantage of being arrogant. If somebody tells you that, the advantage of having a dad like this, or the advantage of your circumstance, that if somebody tells you that you is the worst script in your life, you look at him in a little amused way and walk away, you don't think it's the worst script. Right? You don't think this 10th class pass is going to tell you which is a good script or not. There's nothing wrong with being... class 10, I mean, there's a lot of people who've done research who know nothing, and there's a lot of small people. I'm just saying that this, it's a lack of history, wisdom, and maybe they are right, maybe they don't get it. Yeah? And why should everyone get what you want? Because finally, it's how you put it across,
It's when the film gets made that they know it's Hazaaron. But on, from the page, maybe you can't decipher that.
अच्छे लोगों को पॉलिटिक्स में आना चाहिए लेकिन शुरुआत से अच्छे लोग जो किसी किसी फील्ड में काम कर रहे हैं अचानक वो पॉलिटिक्स में है ये
मेरे हिसाब से कभी गलत नहीं है कोई गलत नहीं है आप कहते हैं जो आप गलत बोल रहे हैं फसल रहे ठेकेदार रह रहे हैं आप कुछ आते भी
नहीं कंट्रीब्यूटिंग ए लॉट फॉर द सोसाइटी
ऑफ कोर्स ही
इज कंट्रीब्यूटिंग
अल्टीमेटली
कंपैरिजन टू एनी एमएलए और
अल्टीमेटली
कंट्रीब्यूटिंग इनका कंट्रीब्यूशन एमएलए और एमपी से कम नहीं
है इनको ये पता ही नहीं कि गोविंदा हिट हो रहा है इनको ये पता ही नहीं कि सुभाष गई डेविड धवन काम कर रहे हैं और करोड़ों लोग उनको देखने जा रहे हैं इन्होंने अपनी अपनी सनक कह लीजिए उसको अपनी सनक में बनाई है फिल्में हिंदुस्तान की राजनीति को इसी साइकोलॉजी की जरूरत है इसी दृष्टि की जरूरत है इलेक्टोरल पॉलिटिक्स उनकी एक जिम्मेदारी है
मैं बताइए अगर लखनऊ का सारा इंटेलेक्चुअल चल पड़ता है इनके साथ सारे रंग कर्मी सारे साहित्य के लोग सारे इस तरह के लोग सारे लोग चल पड़ते हैं तो ये इम्पैक्ट नहीं बनाएगा
अगर आपको लखनऊ से पॉलिटिक्स में आना चाहिए तो सुधीर मिश्रा के जरिए सूर्यमोहन अतुल तिवारी रमेश बहुत लोगों को मतलब ये तो है सूर्यमोहन अतुल तिवारी 50-60 लोग जो कुछ करना चाहते हैं वो आए सब मैं सिर्फ एक जरिया तो पॉलिटिक्स में आने का मतलब है फिर कुछ असर होगा अगर सुधीर मिश्रा सिर्फ पॉलिटिक्स में आएंगे
नहीं होगा
तो कुछ नहीं होगा
ठीक है राइट
फिर वो वही पॉलिटिक्स हुई इंडिविजुअल की सुधीर मिश्रा हो गए थोड़े अच्छे हो गए थोड़ा खुश हो गए कहीं तो कहीं कोई और चला गया कहीं मिनिस्टर बन गए दो चार अच्छी बातें कर ली चले खत्म हो गई जिंदगी
आप देखिए महाराष्ट्र में या कर्नाटक में या साउथ में या बहुत सारी जगह जहाँ का आदमी होता है वहाँ पे उसका थोड़ा सा मान होती है इज्जत होती है वहाँ लोग कुछ करना चाहते हैं उसके जरिए कुछ कर पाते हैं यहाँ तो हम तो खुद ही आए हमको तो किसी बुलाया थोड़ी ना है ना तो हम तो खुद ही चले आए हमको तो 32 साल में किसी ने बुलाया कितना परसेंट हम एजुकेशन पे खर्च करते हैं सर वो पूरा एक ओवरऑल हमारे समाज में हम लोग जो क्या है एलिमेंट्री ट्रेडर्स हो गए और मिमिक्री करते हैं हम लोग चीज़ों की तो वर्ल्ड अकॉर्डिंग टू पी चिदम्बरम यशवंत सिन्हा प्रणब मुखर्जी तो हमारा जो इमीडिएट है वही देखते हैं धंधा तो आप इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर पे खर्च करते हो इस तरह की चीज़ों में जो इमीडिएट बिजनेस को मदद करो जो आपका कल का हिंदुस्तान है उसको आप एक बहुत ही सीमित सा एजुकेशन दे रहे हो जिसमें वो एक सीमित से नौकर बन के रहे
The fact that you're in a black hole in India, the fact that nobody gives a shit, that we don't take care of our history, that we are not interested in anything novel. Indian middle class and the Indian English speaking shadows are big, big problems. That their taste is very limited. So you are faced with that question that yaar main picture bana ke kya kar raha hu, ukhad raha hu. Aisa kya ho jayega? Kaun si duniya badal jayegi? If you look at the quality of music, even those that create them can't claim. They cannot sleep and tell their children this is great music, can they? Can anybody who does that kind of crappy music tell his child that this is great music? He won't tell his child that. He'll tell his child, actually son, I did it for your education so that you buy jeans and Levi's and you can get an American education. Actually this is crap. Go to America and learn good education. So the victory is those of the bazi le gaye kutte. That's true. And the guy who's the, you know, so-called poor idealist, his son will listen to the crappy music and become a moron. Because he'll be left behind, you know. If every place is like every... Now we are building all cantonments for the corporates. It's like cantonments ki usko lage jo corporate traveler hai, wo aaye, to usko wahan pe coffee shop waisi dikh jaye, usko wahi khane ki jagah mil jaye, usko wahi tomato soup ya chicken soup mil jaye, उसको वही वही सब मिले जो उसकी आदत है तो उसको लगे नहीं कि मैं इतना इधर उधर घूम रहा हूँ जैसे पुराने कंटोनमेंट्स हर एक से होते थे ना क्योंकि ट्रांसफर होता था ऑफिसर का
कॉलोनियल
कॉलोनियल
वैसे ही फाइव स्टार होटल बनेंगे, वैसे ही मॉल बनेंगे, वैसे ही सब कंटोनमेंट्स बन रहे हैं फॉर द कॉर्पोरेट सोल्जर.
वी आर ऑल अ बंच ऑफ टेरिफाइड पीपल यू नो, एंड देयर इज अ होल यू नो, इफ यू फेल then there is this, that's why you know you know there's when you grab an opportunity then you sort of tend to go haywire with the opportunity, and then money becomes, you know, because you know the inevitable fallback, there are no cushions, you know, in a world. So that's the difficulty of and the way we, that's how we look at heroes, and it's surprising how all of us do,
you know, in Indians, as we as Indians.
No, but all over the world, I mean, people are looking for demigods, and you know, they seem to get personal about their heroes being attacked. You know, maybe more mature societies or developed people in societies, or people who have grown up and who have the advantage of certain things are not like that. But more or less, it's like that. But here we are much more sensitive, so you cannot sort of discuss them as human beings. You cannot discuss a man who's about to be hanged and who's a hero, and you cannot discuss at that time that he's terrified. That's why, you know, you have this reaction to Siddharth in Hazaaron also, because you think he's a failed hero. Actually, he's not a failed hero, I think. I think he's pretty heroic and a normal human being, you know. It's tough being good in this world, and that's, you don't lose. And then you learn from cinema, and then you understand what you understand from cinema, and then everything is bicycle thieves actually at the end of it. You know, growing up is bicycle thieves, you know, so you admire your father and then he falls from grace. But then you understand him as a human being.
This is where you were exposed to popular Indian cinema, even to Ankur or even to Shyam Benegal, you know, even to Nishant.
This is where I saw, for example, Johnny Mera Naam. Yeah.
कॉफी पीने आते थे भाई, ये सब उस जगह जा रहे हैं जहाँ पे ये बचपन में जाते थे.
अच्छा,
तो अभी यहाँ से निकले तो आपको याद कर रहे थे.
बहुत बढ़िया. अरे देखो यार, बीना से ट्रेन पकड़नी है.
इतनी कॉफी,
बहुत बड़ी कॉफी.
इतनी इतनी कॉफी यार, ट्रेन हम यहीं बुला लेंगे यार, ट्रेन यहीं आएगी.
शूटिंग कैलकटा मेल इन अ ट्रेन, दिस इज एग्जैक्टली द वे इट हैपेंड, एंड आई विल अंडरस्टेट दिस. आई वाज इन शूटिंग कैलकटा मेल, आई गॉट ऑफ द ट्रेन, आई वाज शूटिंग द ट्रेन सीक्वेंस, आई गॉट ऑफ द ट्रेन इन ऑर्डर टू टेक अ लीक. देयर आर दीज, यू नो, stones gathered on side of the track, so my foot kind of slipped on one of them and I went running down the slope. At the end of the slope, my foot hit a larger stone and my ankle twisted. So my leg was, this leg was here, it was here, right? But it perfectly turned, I didn't feel any pain at all of that. Right, so they took me, this is a strange place, I was shooting in Polachi. There was in Polachi, in the middle of nowhere, there's a three-storied orthopedic hospital. This is India. You can die in a great hospital in a big city, and you can have a three-storied special orthopedic, you know, it's another story how that's there. But, so they have to give me anesthesia before they put it back because it paid like hell. So they're trying to give me that. They're checking, doing some physical checkup, right? And they're going to give me anesthesia. My phone rings. There's Vinod on the line. See, there's Vinod on the line. And Vinod said, here, Renu has cancer. Talk to her. And she was giggling on the other side, and I said, I have lymphoma, some Anand kind of. All right. So, you know, I came back and I called some people, and they put me back, and I came here, and that's how I found out. And then she was in the beginning quite hopeful, and they hadn't told her the entire truth. It was quite bad. So I went to a friend of mine who's a oncologist, and he looked at the x-rays and he says, oh my God, oh my God, oh my God. So it was already too late.
Have you begun to miss Renu less professionally?
Yeah, I mean, you have to make do. So have I begun to miss her less? Of course. Both ways, I mean, because life has gone on, you know. Have I stopped missing her? No, I haven't stopped missing her. Of course you stop missing her less. Muddatein guzri teri yaad bhi aayi na hame. Aur hum bhool gaye to usko aisa bhi nahi. Sadness is not a thing people deal with anymore, you know. In a world where someone will be happy and in a buying mood all the time. Let's go and party. In fact, I quietly remember that every time something like that has happened, both when my brother died and when this happened, I avoided going places because, you know, people start getting, you know, walk-in, people get kind of embarrassed, you know. And they say, oh, fuck, he's come now, we'll have to talk about that. And really, people don't have any, they don't even want that kind of thing to enter their heads. Everybody doesn't talk about the dead and, you know, they say, oh, you talk about the dead and everybody gets upset. But you should talk about the dead as if they are alive, you know, because they were part of your life, you know. Right. You know, I mean, because otherwise it's like, you know, you stop talking about them. Mm. And it's as if they never existed.
I am meeting him after 1972.
For the first time?
For the first time.
ये आदमी जितने अड़ंगे लगा सकता था ऐसे ओपन ही नहीं
लगाया
ओपन ही नहीं लगाया लेकिन जितने भी वो क्रिएट कर सकता था ना
मैंने कोई अड़ंग
चाहे गोविंद
दिवेदी कभी लगाया कभी लगाया नेवर नेवर
वी रिमेंबर हिम बेसिकली एज अ रेवोल्यूशनरी काइंड ऑफ अ पर्सन हु वुड नॉट स्टिक टू एनी सिस्टम मतलब ही वाज फॉन्ड ऑफ ब्रेकिंग ऑल सिस्टम्स
ही ऑलवेज हैड अ डेज्ड लुक यू नो एज दो ही इज नॉट टचिंग रियलिटी And what's going on is really not hitting him.
All of them are the same actually.
Yes.
Yeah, तुमने कोई वैसा कोई change
नहीं
किया
तुम्हें
भी नहीं
कोई change कुछ नहीं आया. It's the same.
तुम्हें भी नहीं है तुम्हें भी नहीं है
जैसा पहले ये था. It's the same.
I don't think you have changed.
We've not changed psychologically.
I don't think you have changed much.
We haven't changed psychologically either.
Very unusual because I can still recognize that boy. I can you know like dissolve into that face. It's kind of the same face, it's also older, but it's kind of
same. And the same temperament.
I'm older, yeah. We are all older.
Yeah, if I try to lie to Sudhir, even now, this guy, he's a harsh man, boy. This will be his reaction. Why, boy?
सुधीर का ये हाल रहता था गर्मी में ऐसे ऐसे बैठते थे टाई इधर और यहाँ के दो तीन बटन खुले हुए मैं सैंडल बोलती यू सुधीर You get up. Now, if I also do like this, open my, my this thing, I'm also feeling hot. So Sudhir will say, I don't mind.
I don't mind, huh?
Well, I remember, yeah, then Miss Mendes was like, ek Sunil Shergill tha. Who used to do, pak, 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 pak,
we used to make these sounds, trick was that you don't know from where it comes.
Correct. But invariably
some other guy would get caught.
Prem Prakash khada kar de.
Trick was, it's like a bank and the sound would come, as if come from somewhere else. She was turned to the board and somebody suddenly, pak, 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 she turned. They would not know where. So it's constant. I mean, we used to always get beaten. There was a sister, Jude.
Sister
Jude. Terrible. She was like, I mean, she looked like Sister Jude.
She had a beard.
Not Hey Jude, but you know, Sister Jude. She was like one representative of Nazi time.
Yeah,
that kind of Auschwitz soldier. That kind of person. And her walk towards you meant, you know, she might whack you something. She's terrifying. For a long time later, I've had nightmares of Sister Jude.
And she had a limp, you know.
She had a limp and she walked and she was tall and big and, you know, and
very small.
I later met her, she was very sweet. I met her in Pachmani once, you know, in some retreat.
She was one of those.
Yeah. She was a very sweet lady.
Sister Philomena.
Sort of talking about the Black Sunday, when the Irish got massacred in Dublin, you know, that famous Irish massacre. And
I, as a kid, very clearly remember that we went, we stood for and mourned, and she was crying on stage. You know, and I was standing in the assembly like that, you know, and I was wondering what the hell happened, you know, because, you know, you were crying for mourning for Ireland, you know, sitting in Sagar.
Yes.
पहचान गए
हम तो पहचान गए
यहीं तो रहता था मैं
हाँ मालूम है नहीं पहचान पाया
नहीं धोलू कौन
पप्पू
पप्पू
सदांशु के खास दोस्त
हाँ यहाँ रहते तुम लोग यहाँ कंपाउंडर साहब रहते थे
नहीं के बच्चे तो
नहीं के बच्चे हाँ
भूल गए आप संग में खेले
शादी खेले हाँ अब तुम बदल गए इतने तो मैं कहाँ
जी सर
पापा हमेशा आपके बारे में बताते थे ना हम बताते थे अपने इन-लॉज को बताया था कि ये आपका जब वो आया था ये सारी जिंदगी आया था तो हमने बताया था कि पापा के फ्रेंड एक बार आए थे पापा को पप्पू चाचा को पूछ रहे थे तो पापा बोलने लगे तो उन लोग कहते हैं झूठ बोल रही है उन्होंने कहा नहीं माँ सही में पाए थे आज तो आपको एकदम सामने ही देख लिया अब तो सही में बताऊँगी मैं जाके कि
अब ये बना दिया गया पहले नहीं था ये
तो आंगन की ये दीवार थी वैसे
पूरा बहुत बड़ा आंगन यहाँ जासून लगे थे फूल लगे थे
ये तो सब गार्डन था वो सब खत्म हो गया
पूरा खत्म हो ये किचन थी
दैट वाज माय रूम आई थिंक
दिस वन ये है ना वो तो बंद कर
दो सॉरी आप कैन यू जस्ट Why did the NFDC work? The NFDC worked because an autonomous corporation was created. There were people in there who were independently working. And a lot of people were working there, like Mr. Shyam Benegal and people like that, who were working outside of NFDC support. So they were not dependent on the NFDC for funding. They didn't have a vested interest in it. Right? They had a vested interest in cinema. So, and there were people like Basu Bhattacharya, there were people like Rishikesh Mukherjee, these were people who were not dependent, yet they had wanted atmosphere and another voice and different voices to be heard. They were very encouraging of the young. There was a kind of grace there, you know. They in fact chose to create competition for themselves in a sense, which is, you know, supposed to be, you know, totally the antithesis of what, you know, you're taught in management schools, you know. To give that kind of time is difficult. So Rishida and people like that and Gautam Ghosh and Arvindan and Basu Bhattacharya gave that time.
You're saying, is that the problem, that less of those people give time, or is
less of the people give time, less of those people are there. Less of those people are there, less people with grace.
No, therefore there are less, they are also not allowed to be there, right? Because
no, so they are not allowed to be there. So I mean, everybody wants... I remember Basuda, who was a good friend of mine, you know, just about saying anything to anyone, you know, I mean, in a way which was not, I mean, he was stadium point of view. I mean, I remember Arvindan in his quiet way saying no to many things. I remember, you know, a lot of people were, you know, Rishida could tell a senior secretary to the government of India most anything. All sorts of films are important. It is not economic unviable. Popular cinema is more unviable. Blockbuster cinema, at least in India, is more unviable. One actor whose films have failed, you know, has lost more money than the entire popular film, entire art film movement put together, or parallel cinema movement put together. How much money has, let's say, if we say, what has, and the government also has to find new ways of doing things. You don't have to have this large infrastructure. You don't have to do much. Why should there be entertainment tax?
Have these things ever been discussed?
Does the entertainment tax ever go back to cinema, in developing cinema? Where does the entertainment tax go to? In France, when there's whatever the tax is on Hollywood films, some money out of that is taken into develop French cinema. So where are those methodologies of
why aren't they there?
Because you don't want to create it, because the taste of the idiotic. Everything is supposed to be about one common base. What? The same dull beat? Hammering people into obliterating any sense of anything that they may have, any refinement that they may have. They will not win this battle. These morons from B schools who wear these ties and talk the same crap and talk about good cinema in the evenings and do nothing for it, and who actually have no taste. Right? And I think a different kind of person should come into the production of cinema. He should be a person with some kind of idea of taste, some kind of idea of creating another kind of, you know, environment. And in that environment, you know, it's a honing of a taste of a people, you know, and to interact with ideas, and that's how a society progresses. And that's the idea of a profit of a society as well. So, I mean, the idea of profit even in the corporate sector should change.
Go ahead.
Water, take one.
Action!
I don't like to rehearse too much because it takes away the spontaneity of the shot. I don't like that process too much. I like that time when everything has come together and the lights there, the cameras there, the costume, the set, you know, everything's right, you know, and you're there in that environment and you know about yourself and who that person is. Then, if the casting is right, it kind of works. You know, at that time, I think. There's another energy to it.
He was going, action, he was going. KK, he comes and to my feet of her.
Then there's a pause.
She takes the sandwich and goes. And he looks at her sandwich.
See, like perfect. That. That's really good.
I don't think the sandwich part works.
It works as a completion. Otherwise, every time she's going away do it convincingly, it works. I consciously don't see films when I'm making a film. Especially when I'm editing films, I don't like seeing films. Because there's somebody else's rhythm goes inside your head, you know. So, I mean, I have a tradition and I'm inspired and a lot of people have affected me. But at that time, the fun of it is being on your own, you know. So I also enjoy that process, because every time you write a script, you also find something out about yourself, and it's kind of fun. It's also like a game, no? I mean, making films is also like a mind game. The end of a film, I think, is very important, you know, where you leave. So I love the ends of, say, Martin Scorsese, you know. You take it somewhere in the middle. You know, I mean, of course, all lives end with death and all stories have an end. And mostly the end is kind of sad, you know. You know, so, but, you know, to take life in that spirit of in the middle as a kind of continuity is more, I think, philosophically, in quotes, Indian, you know. And, you know, that's in that sense, I'm Indian.
Is there a leitmotif in your work? Is there some common theme that binds them together? And it's a good time to ask this because, you know, you mentioned so many similarities. Not similarities, but things which are resonant in themes which are resonant in various films. Do you feel that there is, have you ever thought about it, that there is something that is common to your...
Somebody has to see, you know, I mean, I you make films, but they're mostly... I mean, you could say that, you know, somebody was saying that, you know, and I'm not borrowing from what other people have commented, you know. So, I mean, somebody said that it's the anatomy of grace, you know. In 1987, there were 20 of us in the Tokyo Film Festival, you know, there was people like Aki Kasmaki. We sort of had a two-hour meeting, which is difficult, we forced the meeting almost. And here he's saying that, you know, always make the film. The producer doesn't never make the film, he said. Kurosawa said, never make the film that producer wants to make, you to make, or you what you don't want to make. You make the film that you want to make. So somebody says, how? So he says, you know, if you're a filmmaker, you should have at least 20 scripts in your head, because you're making either the same film in different ways, or you're making different films, or whatever the kind of filmmaker you are, but you should have more than 20 stories to tell. So if the producer says, what about this? And he may be right, because he at that moment he doesn't consider it marketable enough. You say, okay, not this, but what about this, you know? And if not that, then what about this? And I have one here, and you know, I mean, and if Kurosawa it can happen to, why can't, you know, who the hell are you, you know, come on. The advantage with guys like us is that we have a story every third day. So if you tell me, okay, scrap all the scripts that you have in your head, all the films that you have in your head, now start. So I'll tell you a story 3 days later. You know, I mean, so that's what they can't get you with. They can't, you know, they will sit and they will think of this project or that project, and every day, after one story, they run out. See, they think that you are bullshitting and talking crap and discussing and sitting at nights and having a discussion where you know, whether Brecht was better or Shaw was better or what. But you, they don't understand that you treat them as live things and those works. So you are interacting with, it's like saying my son is better, your son is better. It's a live thing for us. So that's also, we are using it to provoke ourselves and your head, so that you can work. There's a function there. Actually, we are kind of working when we are fighting and drinking. Right? And that's the atmosphere that's kind of going. Because that's a provocation that you're doing to yourself. You're allowing somebody, a friend of yours, attack you. You're trying to dismantle some things in your head. You know, that's the important. So I don't think anybody who keeps going on like that, I don't think they can stop. So maybe Saeed Mirza, they think they stop, but he's written a book. So maybe at the end of it, 5 books later, some crappy commercial filmmakers will disappear and the books will remain. So how do they know whether they destroyed it? Maybe they did him a service. If you want to take life and if you want to not sell a pipe dream and the difference between advertising and stories, you know, and slogans and dialogue, you know, and spoken word and films, then, you know, there are no pipe dreams, there are no fancy ends, there is life, and it has surprises, and it cannot be encompassed by any one thing. And there is no one cure for all ills. You know, there is what is at the end of the rainbow, you know, I don't know. But, you know, there is no, mostly out of necessity people dump each other. Betrayal is sometimes necessary.
Suppose you were a new filmmaker in today's environment. You were a first-time filmmaker in today's environment. What would you do differently? I mean, or would you do anything differently?
I don't know. Today, I'm not sure whether, I mean, see, you know, what is the place of cinema? I mean, when we made films, started making films, or when the earlier generations, they were very sure that there was this medium called cinema is going to change the world. There is going to be this great excitement, the, you know, the world is going to become a different place. There is, we're going to explore values, you know, things will, you know, be. Then you know that cinema doesn't have that much of an impact. You know, you get to know that as you grow up, you know, that, you know, the world continues and gets more retarded at times, and some moments you see some light, and, you know, there are all these things happening simultaneously. So today, I don't know. I mean, it's more confusing for a kid today starting out. So it'd be more confusing for me. But, you know, I would say that the only thing is to tell personal stories. I would say that, you know, what can you do except express yourself in your time, you know, and to tell stories like that, you know, and to be very interested in craft. And to take that over some kind of edge.
Do you think this defacing of the wall actually represents India even more?
Lord.
No, this is as. This is as.
एक पंकज भी है.
देखो.
This is as relevant as to Indian culture as the ruins itself.
I don't know if it's relevant to Indian culture. It is. I think the problem is that we have not, we always complain, huh? And we Indians this have typically your habit. Mm-hmm. Everybody is bad except me.
Achha.
Right. Yeah. But we have left a whole, it's this upper class, upper caste thing where people have not been exposed to culture and have been left bereft of things. So they tend to be very destructive, like monkeys without a habitat. Long live Bharat Mata ki Jai, no? That's all. It's just a word, no?